Están los libros. Tú no lo sabes porque solo piensas en tu próximo polvo, pero son las condiciones iniciales del sistema las que determinan su evolución.
It's the condition within the system that determines the reaction. Muy sencillo. So let's just look at this again here. Got a lot of terms going through here.
No es actitud, Pablo. Es ciencia. Están los libros. Tú no lo sabes porque solo piensas en tu próximo polvo, pero son las condiciones.
Okay, listen, we've got my neighbors upstairs arguing. If you can hear that, that's the relationship going bad. But you don't know because all you think about is getting laid. But the initial
iniciales del sistema, las que determinan
conditions within. Siri says, ¿cómo? What's up?
No es actitud, Pablo. Es ciencia. Están los libros. Tú no lo sabes porque
I don't know because I think I was getting laid.
Lo piensas en tu próximo polvo, pero son las condiciones iniciales.
The initial conditions within a system are what determine its evolution. So right here, we just looked at the system. So there's the system at the bottom. The initial conditions in the system, pressure, volume, and temperature, which go way beyond what we're talking about here. A, B, react within the system. Or A and B react within the system. And the initial conditions in the system, for example, temperature, pressure, volume are what determine the reaction to the actuate. So you think it's just A and B. You also have to take into account the system that you're reacting in. That's what he's trying to say here.
Del sistema, las que determinan su evolución.
¿Qué?
Muy sencillo. Tenemos un sistema y una diferencia de temperatura entre las partes. Luego ya se ha puesto en marcha la segunda ley de la termodinámica.
¿Cuál era la segunda ley?
The second law of thermodynamics is one of the strangest laws in nature.
Introduce a new concept, which is difficult to grasp, but there is no way to escape it.
This concept raises very profound questions about reality and even about the meaning of time and the destiny of the universe.
It does mean that any system evolves and degrades to some extent.
It seems to suggest why the future goes in a particular direction.
Things get worse.
I think we all notice that.
This concept is known as entropy.
Pero, ¿qué es la entropía? Prepárense para entender de una vez por todas algo que ya nunca podrán olvidar.
We have already talked about entropy when we talked about the first law.
Entropy measures the degradation of good energy into the form of heat.
In any isolated system, the entropy...
Okay. So right there she said, entropy measures the degradation of good energy into the form of heat. That's incorrect. If I heard things.
This concept is known as entropy.
Right here is the way the things break, Cupid is breaking off. This is called the disorder model of entropy. It's incorrect. It comes from Boltzmann, gas theory, and it got extrapolated up to the universe, which is kind of like a small unique system approximation of things, and they took it as matter of fact, and then we learn about this in terms of society supposedly works. Everything gets broken and turns into dust in the end. This is incorrect.
Pero, ¿qué es la entropía? Prepárense para entender de una vez por todas algo que ya nunca podrán olvidar.
Chris, let's try and look at this in terms of, because the explanation you're going to get is going to be incorrect. So Manel, he has his first girlfriend over here, and she's more intelligent than she is, but she's more physically attractive than she is. And so he dumps her, or maybe and so he starts dating her. And Pablo is dating Eva. So we've got five chemical species, A, B, C, D, E, and that's their system, their orbitals. So to explain entropy, the sun heats the surface of the Earth once per day, and that creates an increase in the volume of the system. The piston goes up, and then when the sun goes down, the piston goes down because heat leaves the system. So we have a daily cycle of dq over t entering the system at day and dq over t leaving the system at night. So in between those two transformations, we have what's called the equivalence value of all uncompensated transformations. That comes from Clausius. That means that the internal work that the molecules of the system, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, do on each other, is not necessarily, doesn't tensor its disorder. It's a transformed internal work. So we can't measure this internal work. We can measure the, let me look at this here. Here it is right here. So when you see Lyle's babble about the vase being broken, technically what they're talking about is this n value. It's called the equivalence value of all uncompensated transformations. So this n is where entropy increase is measured. Because we can't measure it exactly, they say that Clausius reformulated this that says that transformation equivalents increase over time. But technically, there's nothing about heat death in here or the end of the universe space. It's the measure, there's a measurement of this internal work that's of heat going into the system versus heat going out of the system gets lost in terms of, not lost, but transformed in terms of internal work, which means people doing work on each other. Like you push me, I push you, that kind of thing. And we have our occupations. So it's called the equivalence value of internal irreversible work that exists at the end of one cyclical process, that means one daily heat cycle, that are called the uncompensated transformations. The equivalence value of all uncompensated transformations was an early extended synonym for what would famously be called entropy in 1865 by Clausius. So we'll just watch, keep moving on here.
I've already talked about entropy when we talked about the first law.
Entropy measures the degradation of good energy into the form of heat.
Yep, you see there. Good.
In any isolated system, the entropy will always increase.
It gets larger and larger every second. That's the second law of thermodynamics.
Entropy is a measure of energy that is lost and cannot be recovered. Even though heat is one of the most common forms of energy transfer we are used to in our daily life, it's very inefficient.
Gotta cover up the sexual sins. Okay, we'll just use a book.
Not create anything from heat. So heat and entropy is a bad thing.
Heat is the most random.
See, that was just stupid comments right there. Heat and entropy are a bad thing. The person who said that was ignorant. For example, if you wake up tomorrow and the sun is shining, and you go to the park, you look up at the sun and you say, whoa, this heat coming down on me, making the flowers grow is a bad thing. It's kind of like a Sokol affair. Sokol affair is when information has become too complex that you can't understand it anymore. So you end up saying things that are nonsensical.
And low quality form of energy.
Oh, watch out.
You need a
I'll cover this up.
Huge amount of heat to obtain minimum performance.
For example, let's compare it to the breaking of a nucleus in an atom.
Heat is the byproduct of an engine's operation.
That's why entropy is a measure of useless, wasted energy.
Okay, that's just stupid right there. We'll just keep going forward.
Pero la cosa no termina aquí. Hay otra forma de ver la entropía aún más desconcertante, aún más devastadora.
He pasado toda la noche pegándola.
No hacía falta, Tampoco te ha quedado tan mal.
Con lo que te costó hacer.
Que no te preocupes, porque así tiene incluso más personalidad. A ver, tampoco era tan bonita la escultura. Bueno, esta semana no voy a poder verte, Manel, porque voy a estar muy liada con el corto. Si quieres, puedes venir al rodaje a verme, pero ya te aviso que no te voy a hacer mucho caso.
Ya te vas, pero si acabas de llegar.
No me puedo quedar, lo siento. Tengo ensayo. ¿Va todo bien?
No sé. ¿Va todo bien? Ayer no contestaste a mis mensajes.
No te contesté. Vaya. Siento estar tan liada, de verdad.
Es solo eso.
Es solo eso. No te rayes. Igual estás yendo un poco deprisa, pero está todo bien, ¿vale? Nos vemos el domingo.
They're starting the breakup phase right here. Uncoupling of the bond.
Suerte.
Less exchange force.
Heat on a microscopic level is the movement of the particles that form the system.
The fact that you have heat means that the particles will get agitated.
The hotter the system, the faster particles move. And the cooler is the system, the more quiet and more ordered are the particles.
Therefore, entropy can also be seen as a measure of the disorder of the system.
Okay, that just... So now we're talking about entropy is not a measure of the disorder of the system. There's only... one way you can look, there's a little bit of truth to this. If you add heat to, say, an ice cube, it's going to turn into vapor. But that doesn't mean that it's more disordered. And if you go through Norman Doloff's book, The Heat Death in the Phoenix, which we just looked at, explains this whole thing in terms of you start looking at molecules in terms of energy and entropy. I don't know if I can find it right now, but if he starts talking about, so right here we're talking about, so before we're talking about the exchange force is different. Yeah, if you're a carbon atom, your exchange force can be different force can be felt differently if you're a hydrogen atom. Because carbon has two bonds going out of its way, hydrogen has one bond. So Dolev talks about how if you measure the entropies and free energies of these different chemicals, that the concept of order and disorder goes out the window. It doesn't make any sense anymore. Very, very good book.
The higher the entropy, the more disorder. And less likely it will be to find a particle in its original position.
Hola, perdona. Vengo a ver a Elena. Soy Manel.
¿Manel? ¿Qué Manel? ¿Sí, se han ido?
¿Cómo que se han ido? Si me han dicho hace 10 minutos que estaban aquí.
El resto del día van a estar rodando en otro sitio, como a 2 horas de aquí.
There are many configurations of particles in a system, and most of them are disorganized, and only a few of them are organized. And that means that entropy tends to increase. Disorder will dominate.
Okay. Again, that's just more ignorance. It says something about entropy will tend to increase and disorder will tend to dominate. Again, that goes back to the value of N, which is called the equivalence value of uncompensated transformations. This thing has kind of been like a cultural, so the N will increase right here, but the, it has nothing to do with disorder. It's a measure of the equivalence value of all uncompensated transformations. I can't explain that right now, but it's going to be in the book coming up here. Once it gets finished, it's one of the Clausius chapters. But N is the measure of the heat that goes in, subtracted from the heat goes out. There's going to be a difference that's left over. It's called this N value. And it's the amount of internal work the molecules of the system do on each other. Doesn't have anything to do with order or disorder. It's kind of like a 155 years worth of ignorance that we're still teaching on these films. If you read Clausius, you won't be ignorant anymore. Is basically what I'm trying to say.
As a consequence of this growing disorder, which is a loss of useful energy, in order to maintain a machine in function, we need to supply new energy from outside.
¿Y si hacemos un trío?
No es mi intención.
No era mi intención asustarle, pero debo decirle que su tesis avanza mucho más lento de lo esperado.
Me llevo como el culo.
También se puede expresar así, sí. En estos momentos hay mucha gente trabajando en la termodinámica de los sistemas complejos. Si no se da prisa, ¿quién podía adelantarse?
Estoy hasta el gorro de termodinámica y de sistemas complejos.
¿Sabía usted que una gran parte de los físicos que desarrollaron la termodinámica se suicidaron? O peor aún, lo intentaron sin éxito. Alguno incluso perdió a su mujer y a sus hijos en el intento.
Let's just watch this again here, because
en estos momentos hay mucha gente trabajando en la termodinámica de los sistemas complejos. Si no se da prisa, ¿quién podía adelantarse?
Estoy hasta el gorro de termodinámica y de sistemas complejos.
¿Sabía usted que una gran parte de los físicos que desarrollaron?
So he says, you know, a lot of founders of thermodynamics committed suicide, and he also says,
se suicidaron, o peor aún.
Or even worse, they tried unsuccessfully. He's talking about Robert Meyer, who jumped out of the third floor of an insane asylum, one of the founders of the first law of thermodynamics.
Lo intentaron sin éxito.
And then,
alguno incluso perdió,
or even worse, their wives and children were well trying. So he's talking about Henry Adams' wife, who killed himself while he was working on formulating human thermodynamics, and then the children of Fritz Haber, who killed themselves. And Fritz Haber is one of the founders of gas-based thermodynamics. So when he's talking about, or even lost their wives and children while trying. So Haber wrote Thermodynamics of Technical Gas Phase Thermodynamics. After he wrote this, his wife and his children killed themselves. So he got the Mateo Gil got this from my online article. Certainly I wasn't the first to summarize, point out this commonality, but right here we have, it's called Founders of Thermodynamics and Suicide. So here we have the first three laws of thermodynamics. Gilbert Lewis. Okay, so first was Mayer. He's the one who attempted suicide. I thought we were just, the cover's looking at. He jumped out of a window of an insane asylum because he found out that James Joule formulated the first law of the mechanical theory of heat before him. It was time and credit, or J is equal to the work divided by Q. And then Boltzmann hung himself, as we've talked about, after formulating this, or owing to debates with Ernest Mach, or Mach and Rehnquist, someone else, about that atoms didn't exist. And now Gilbert Lewis, he's one of the big bosses. So he wrote, he's the guy that summarized Willard Gibbs' chemical thermodynamics. And he drank cyanide when he was 70 after Irving Langmuir won the Nobel Prize before him and claimed all the credit for his work. But Gilbert Lewis is probably the most intelligent of the three. But what he's talking about, the film is talking about down here, is if we go down here, we have Percy Shelley, who was the first person who applied affinities to social reactions. And he was kind of like a follow-up to Goethe, but he got expelled from Oxford. And then affinity is the force of the chemical reactions. And Helmholtz is the one who showed that the Gibbs free energy is the of the system. So let's look at this here, so I can get this straight. So the affinities between the two, each individual species is called affinity or chemical affinity. But then when you get into the system, all the affinities, the measure of the micro affinities is called the free energy of the system. So before, this wasn't developed until 1882. So Percy Shelley wrote up this whole thing, and he got married to Mary Shelley, the author of Frankenstein, in what he called the Church of Elective Affinities, because he threw out religion, but they ended up, he drowned himself when he was 29. And then if we go down here, now what he's talking about in the film just now about the wives who killed themselves or took their own existences, he's talking about Henry Adams here. So the, whoever wrote this, Mateo Gil, must have read this article that I wrote and added this into the film. So he says, Henry Adams spent 50 years trying to figure out how chemistry and thermodynamics applies to history. And he says, at the age of 47, social chemistry is the mutual attraction and repulsion of equivalent human molecules, is a science yet to be created for fact is my daily study and only satisfaction in existence. So his female one is his first wife, Elizabeth Cameron, age 28 here. And Henry Adams, you know, is the second or third, the grandson of John Adams, the third or fourth president of America. And then he had this female too is Clover Adams. Which she killed herself after this new female came into the picture. But he's thinking about this all in terms of chemistry. So he said, talking about the wives of these founders killed him. So he's one of the founders of human chemical thermodynamics. And then he also talks about she killed herself by drinking